What's going on, everybody? My name is Michael, your RV guy here at the Great Outdoors RV in Greeley, Colorado. Today, we are gonna go over a Rockwood Roo. This is a 2024 235S. This is probably their most popular floor plan when it comes to their hybrid trailers. I think the benefit of going to a hybrid really just comes down to it's a super lightweight travel trailer that can sleep a ton of people. So if that's what you're looking for, this might be perfect for you. Let's start right off at the front here. Two 20-pound tanks with a tank cover, electric tongue jack, so super easy to go up and down. Room for two batteries, and they give you the battery box that fits two batteries. If you do want to go to 6-volt, run those in parallel, that battery box does fit that as well. Underneath your propane tanks there too, it's kind of hard to see with the camera, but you do have a battery disconnect right there at a convenient location. We do have pass-through storage in this thing. It's not very big, but you can fit your camp chairs, your fishing poles, and all those little things. Maybe your camp carpet that you want to fit on the outside of the storage and compartments. We do have this massive, and dude, I have no idea what I was just saying there, the outside of the storage of the compartments.
That's okay.
You know what I mean, though?
Yeah, I know.
But we got outside kitchen here, two burner cooktop. Now, it is a Rockwood, so we are, as a standard feature, going to get a 17-inch griddle that will mount to the side here, too. So if you're like Gordon Ramsay and just need to cook everything, you got all the options right here. So two burner cooktop. That is a nice little option there. And we have a beer fridge here, a juice box fridge, or popsicle fridge, because we do have a freezer, kid. Come on now. Good size cubby here. Your cabinets. It's been a little bit since we've done this video. You're gonna have to bear with me here. We got rock solid hardwood cabinets. Come on now. That's your outside cabinet. Most of the time you're getting particle board in this price point. So that's huge. Let's go right down the side here. We do have a TV mount, so you can throw your TV outside here if you want to watch the game. We do also, along with that 17-inch griddle, get a little prep table as well. And then this was actually pretty smart. We got water access out here too, so you can wash off all your cooking utensils when you're done using them. Standard feature on a Rockwood here, we do have Goodyear tires. That is absolutely huge. That is what most people will end up upgrading to over time when they end up getting into camping. They are nitrogen filled, and then the axles on a Rockwood are independent. Most of the time in this price point, you're getting what's called leaf spring, which is basically just a bar, your two tires, and then your camper welded to the top of it. So every time you take a dip, your camper dips with it. With a Rockwood, one tire goes down, the other goes up, your camper rides smooth the entire time. So it's kind of like a horse trailer. You want to treat this thing like it's a house on wheels, get yourself some nice axles, kid. Frameless windows, that's another standard feature here in a Rockwood. Most of the time in this price point, you're gonna have what looks like a rubber seal going around the outer edge of that window. The problem with that is with all this sun that we're getting smacked with every day, that's probably gonna end up cracking and allowing water to seep down your sidewall. So frameless window is a big upgrade because all of your ceiling for your window is behind the tint. So you're not gonna have to worry about that cracking on you over time. Two outside speakers, and then the way that Rockwood does it when it comes to their framing and their sidewalls, this is huge for you. 6-point aluminum structure, so that means your truss system and your floor system is all framed in aluminum along with your sidewalls and front cap and rear cap. So most of the time in that price point, you're getting a wood truss system and then a wood floor, but they market that the whole camper is framed in aluminum. That's just not true, but that's a huge feature that Rockwood does as a standard. They also don't use any wood in their sidewalls. They use a material called Asdel to replace what they normally use wood for. So the way they do these walls is you got your fiberglass, usually you got a thin layer of wood, your insulation, more wood, and then wallpaper. They replace those two thin layers of wood with Asdel, which is a composite material, so it's a plastic, so no mold or mildew buildup, and it's lighter weight. That's huge. Coming into your entry door here, you do have the shade that comes as a standard feature. Solid steps. Everybody loves solid steps. You're not gonna complain about it, right, Nick?
That's right.
That's right. Looking on the back here, we do have your bumper guard, so you can throw your stinky slinky right in there. We have a spot for your spare tire, and I believe we got some extra storage back here. Yep. So extra little outside storage right next to your wet bay here. This does have a black tank flush on it right out of the factory, so it'll make it a lot easier for dumping your tanks, your city water connection, antifreeze inlet, your cable hookups, and this is your 30-amp plug for the unit right here. And we do give you a 30-amp power cord too, so that way you can go camping right away. So on a Rockwood as well, we want to make sure we mention that these are they have the four season capabilities. What that basically means is you got 12 volt heat pads on the bottom of your tanks here that you can control right from a touch of a button on your control panel. Now, a lot of folks talk about four season camping. Just know that you're gonna have to do a couple of things to make sure that you're completely safe to four season camp, because a lot of folks use these as, you know, hunting trailers or what have you in the wintertime. But it's nice to know you have all those extra options to keep the camper warm. There's always gonna be stuff you need to do. Don't let anybody tell you that you can use this camper full capacity all season long. So that's good to know. Looking on the inside here, we got a ton of storage. I mean, this, like I told you on the outside, the whole idea with a hybrid trailer is that you want to sleep a lot of people. So there's going to be a lot of people in here. So let's start off with the kitchen. Let's talk about that. Huge pantry right here. Fit all your stuff inside. You got cabinets going along the entire kitchen area. Good size sink. More cabinets underneath. You're not going to have a problem fitting all your stuff in here. In fact, the only way you're gonna have a problem is if you forget it at home, kid. Three burner cooktop with a countertop extension. Bada bing. Good spot to put your kitchen knives right there so that way they don't move around during transit. And then behind me here, we even got some more pantry space too. And what's nice about this one is you can remove these shelves here if you wanna use it as hanging space. So let's talk about sleeping arrangements now. We got your dinette here that will fold down to a bed. Theater seating right next to it. And then I'll switch spots with Nicholas here. And we got first bed right here. So these mattresses on a hybrid trailer are just like a pop-up. They're heated. So you can keep these windows open at night and keep your heated mattress going, and you're gonna probably sleep completely comfortable. What's nice about this is you can flip that over. You got a little bit of end bench right here that you can put your shoes on, or when you're thinking about the fact that there's probably gonna be quite a few people in here at times, it's nice to have a little bit of extra seating. Some more storage underneath. Your inverter right here. So on the roof of this camper, you got 200 watts of solar as a standard feature. We do put an additional solar panel on it, so you have 400 watts. And then for 2024, they upgraded their inverter size. Last year, they had a 1,000-watt inverter. This year, they have an 1,800-watt inverter. What that basically just means to you is that you have a little bit more capabilities when it comes to off-grid camping. Inverters allow you to use some of the outlets on the inside of your camper when you're off-grid camping. And now that you have 1,800 watts, you can charge your phone, use a CPAP machine, and a couple other little items that might be nice to have when you're off-grid camping. We do have a fireplace on this unit that will put off about 10 to 15 degrees of electric heat, which is nice because you're saving on gas. Your TV comes with the unit, and then behind your TV, you got some additional storage too, and you even have some hanging space up there too, which is nice. As a standard feature again here, max air fan with the max air fan cover, and you also have one in the bathroom as well. Those max air fans are huge. They're designed to circulate the air to camper about this size three times every 60 seconds, so huge. Right, kid?
Mm-hmm.
Huge.
Huge.
Black glass, what do you call it? Black glass-faced fridge. Bang. This is all scratch proof, brand new to Rockwood. You're seeing this in a lot of Forest River products. With one cool thing about the way that these fridges work is they open up from both sides. So it's kind of like a quirky thing, but there are definitely some benefits to that. You know, if you're just trying to come in and out real quick and you want to open up the fridge from this side to grab a drink or something, nice that it's a little bit easier for you. But just make sure that one of the sides is locked before you open it up, so that way you don't take the entire fridge off the wall there. So that'd be good to know, right? Let's switch spots here, Nicholas. Let's show off bathroom, other bed here. So we got the other bed right here that folds out, your control panel. So this is where you can control your tank heaters, your slide, awning, all your lights. You can read your levels on your tanks, your battery, all that jazz. Again, heated mattress, more storage space underneath the bed there as well. Let's check out bathroom. So we got radius shower. Let's see how much room we got. So I'm about 5'7", and I got at least a half a foot above my head. So plenty of room to stand around. And it's very comfortable in here. We got medicine cabinet, good size sink, a lot of counter space on this. And then check out this little cubby here to put all your linens and towels away. Like I said, max air fan, standard feature in the bathroom with the max air fan cover. And then porcelain toilet. One big thing about the Rockwood showers that you should definitely know is they come standard with a shower miser. So when you're looking in here, you got that blue rubber seal. That blue rubber seal tells me it's not ready. The whole idea here is you want to flip that lever right next to the rubber seal when you turn the hot water on. And instead of allowing that water to come out for about, you know, 2 minutes to warm up, it bypasses, goes back into the hot water heater, heats to a certain temperature, and then that blue rubber seal turns red. Once that rubber seal is red, you flip the lever back and now the water's coming out at the perfect temperature. So you save about 2 to 3 gallons every time you take a shower, which is nice. So again, we are in the 2024 Rockwood Roo 235S, probably their most popular hybrid travel trailer. My name is Michael here at the Great Outdoors RV in Greeley, Colorado. Give us a call at 970-313-4337 or feel free to come by and take a look at this thing. We appreciate you guys watching and we'll catch you guys next time.